Jimmy Hopps kom til Norge i juni 1971 som deltaker ved jazzfestivalen i Kongsberg med Webster Lewis Quintet. Han ble i Norge 6 måneder og utviklet i løpet av denne tiden et nært samarbeid med blant annet Calle Neumann, Arild Andersen og Jan Garbarek. Sammen med disse øvde han inn et program med egne komposisjoner under fellestitelen Exchanges, og det fra Voss Gymnas vi skal høre opptak av dette. Jimmy Hopps begynte først i 20-årsalderen å spille trommer, men for sitt nære samarbeid med blant annet trompeteren Charles Tolliver og saxofonisten Pharaoh Sanders står han i dag som en av de mest respekterte yngre trommeslagere i USA.
Yeah. Oh, we're just starting to climb now.
Yeah.
Yes, you notice? Here we go. Yeah.
You have been living your life in America, yeah? Playing the music that you play there. And you come here to this country and you meet with Jan and Arild and Calle, and you get together and you play jazz. You play jazz music. There are some connections to the past, yeah, in this music?
Oh, yeah, sure it is. I mean,
they must be different for you than for them, or maybe not.
That's the question. That's what I'm trying to find out. What is the difference, you know? Where the difference lies. But what I found out in traveling around the world is that when you get to a certain point in communication, and especially like for me with music, then I find with so much similarity between us. You know, it seems like the music gives us the opportunity to be, I say, outside of the things that make up our ordinary existence. In other words, music takes me to a point where I'm no longer African or American or Norwegian or Swedish or German. And that's why that's the reason I keep on playing. Otherwise I would stop, because the music business is no good at all, you know. But the thing about it is that when you get on the bandstand or you get with the musicians, we go someplace that's beyond all of that. You know? And I have that more often in that experience than I have in any other. So I keep playing. And I travel and play with more musicians every place you go, you know? Really, I think that's the advantage. You find out that we're all the same, man. It's no different. The experience is this, you know, I mean, the way that we look at life, you know?
Men det er så likt at det er sånn folkemusikk. I Norge har vi hardingfele. Og rett over så har de sekkepiper, og det låter likt. Det låter helt likt.
Skål.
Ja, det låter helt likt. Det er helt to forskjellige instrumenter. Det låter helt likt. Klistremaker.
But when you get down to subjective levels, then it's a big difference. The fact that I come from originally from Africa and then spend 400 years or so in North America, and the fact that he comes here from Norway, you know, different, we all come together, you know.
But now you're choosing to go back to Africa.
Yeah, yeah. I have to go because I'm so ignorant as an African of the motherland, you know. I think all people have a attraction for the motherland, whatever it is, you know. And so what I find out is that in the 400 years or so that Africans have been in North America, they have been separated from Africa. You know, their education, formal education, everything, the way of life and everything, has nothing whatsoever to do with Africa, subjectively. I mean, you're supposed to forget that you are of African descent. But yet and still, the society doesn't allow me to forget, because I'm not incorporated into the society to the extent where I could just forget about that. And then I have certain things that I look at when I wake up in the morning, and I look in the mirror and I see that my complexion is so-and-so, and then I see that the texture of my hair is so-and-so, you know, and I look in the mirror and I see the shape of my body and the structure of my feet, and then I go to the different sciences, you know, or the universities and things, and they say, well, this is because of certain reason for that. In other words, you need this texture or color of skin in order to help you with the sun. Where you originally come from, the sun is so strong, you see, that you need this protection of the skin and of the hair. You see what I mean? And so, but I say, well, look, I'm born in Washington, D.C. I don't need this anymore. But it hasn't gone anywhere. You see? It hasn't gone away. So then I start to think about, well, what does this mean, you know, that these are superficial things, you can say, you know. I say, well, what does that mean? I go and ask, you go to universities, you go to libraries, you go to professors and doctors, and nobody can tell you anything. All during the first, you know, you can go to college and the universities and things in the States, and you don't find out anything about Africa. Mm.
There's good food.
Oh. Har den hotell, it's right here.
Har du spilt der?
Nei.
Hotell? Jeg har spilt der.
Oh, man. It...
We are going north. Mm.
I think you can do that,
so we are on again.
It's gonna need way out.
Thank you. Mm-hmm.